What's going on, people? We are Tottenham TV here. Tottenham 1, Liverpool 3 in an absolutely disastrous defeat. You got to say, I think we came out of the blocks well today in the first 20 minutes. We really showed kind of what we're about. I thought we were looking like it was going to be a really good game for us. And it looked like that we were coming up. We looked like the better team in the first 20 minutes. And then we just imploded today, Sim. We just absolutely imploded. Liverpool kind of were gradually getting back into the game in that second half. Got that killer blow just before the end of the first half. And then they got the real killer blow just in first minute of the second half. And then it was just a shambles from then.
Yeah, I'm so angry about how we came out in that second half. I really am. It was actually a shambles and pretty pathetic from the side who I thought competed really well in that first half, and I was actually pretty happy with how the game was going. And I thought, you know, going to half time, I thought we had a fair bit of control of the game. Although Liverpool were having a bit too much space in the central midfield for my liking, I thought we contained them fairly well. They weren't creating too many great chances. They made one right at the start of the game from Mane. Apart from that, I can't remember too many clear-cut chances they had. Son obviously had that goal which was ruled out from a hair's width offside. And he had another chance as well where he was one-on-one and he hit it straight at Alisson with his left foot. And so I thought Spurs were looking all right, and there were, you saw opportunities there for us to exploit Liverpool, the space Liverpool were leaving. So I was like, this is going on. But then Kane went down once, and I'm like, oh God. And then he goes down again, and he's not looking happy. I'm like, hopefully he can run it off. And
I think you could tell from the second time he went down that he actually
That's when it all started to fall apart, because Kane was giving Henderson a real tough time. Yeah. He was causing problems for Liverpool. He was making it stick when he went up front, and we were playing balls into him, and he was making things happen. But as soon as he started getting injuries and he got holding his ankle and he just looked gingerly, and then it started to go wrong. Then all of a sudden Liverpool could push up.
Is that a mentality issue or a personnel issue?
Both.
Yeah.
Both. We need to find ways of playing without Kane, and we struggled big time.
I mean, we found ways without playing without Kane with Pochettino.
Yeah, against the two teams is good. I guess maybe City we did.
Yeah.
But then again, we beat City with Jose without
Kane. I mean, we got to the Champions League final without Harry Kane.
Yeah. It was only a half football, but it's not like it's a running theme. But in terms of this half, in terms of today, we were diabolical in that second half. First of all, going back to that goal in the right at the end of the first half, shambles, absolute shambles between Dyer and Lloris, and Aurier.
Dyer leaves it for Lloris. Lloris is leaving it for Dyer. Nobody knows what they're doing
behind him. Shambles. I don't know where Roden was. I have to see the goal again. I don't know where he was, but Mane get the ball across the face of goal, which is a good ball, but you know, Lloris and Dier leave it for each other. There's no communication. It's shocking. And to do that with the last kick of the half is unforgivable. And it was always going to be 10 times harder once you do that against Liverpool, because the game plan was to keep it compact, attack when we can, and make sure we restrict Liverpool to chances. But you can't do that when you're 1-0 down. You just can't, because you need to be getting the ball up the pitch, and you need to be creating chances because you're losing. And I would say credit to Mourinho for changing at half time to try and force the issue, but he got it wrong. He just got it totally wrong with his substitutions. I don't know.
I mean, Lamella and Winks were both dog, weren't they? The absolute dog.
Well, first of all, Kane went off injured, I'm assuming. Yeah. I have to be. And then Aurier, and then I don't know if Aurier went off, I don't know if he was injured or not. If he wasn't injured, I thought it was an awful decision to keep Doherty on.
I mean, surely he had to be injured.
Why? If he's
not injured, why would he not take
Shocking.
Off Matt Doherty?
Because Doherty, he's struggled in a back four. He moved to a back four in the second half. He's struggled all season in a back four.
In a back five, never mind a back four.
Yeah, but we know he doesn't have the pace to get back in position when he goes forward, and we need him to get forward in this game if we're going to be getting back in the game. And every time he went forward, we were left so open at the back, so open every single time. And it's not totally his fault because it's a team dynamic. But
it's also his fault for every time he gets the ball. He can't even pass it to a player in
wide. He was horrific today, Matt Doherty. I was not
Matt
happy
Doherty
with him.
Matt Doherty was awful. Harry Winks, when he came on, he couldn't pass it to a player wide. Not even
I actually think he might
stick up for Harry Winks today.
I actually think he was the worst player on the pitch when he came on, Winks. And, you know,
Eric Lamella, absolutely anonymous awful. When he came on.
We came out in that second half, and you saw right at the start, it was totally wrong. Right at the start, their first attack, they get a goal. Another poor save by Lloris, I actually thought, because it's a weak effort for Mane, despite it was going in the corner, and it was like, and it was good accuracy, but it was not a lot of power, and he could have very, very easily tipped out for a corner. Yeah. Very easily.
And, you know,
and he decided not to.
We've like commended Lloris time and time again since he's come back from injury. Best goalkeeper in the Premiership, or definitely in the top two at least. But today, what you've got to say is it's another mistake in a high-profile game. Another two high-profile mistakes potentially there.
Yeah, I mean, it's the first time he's done it for a while. But really, a lack of communication really cost us. And especially that second goal, that really annoyed me, because he could have easily tipped that away. That shot wasn't that good, that had to be tipped to Alexander-Arnold. And then he forced Alexander-Arnold, he smashes it, and it's 2-0. And at that point, I was ready to give up because I knew it was game over. We'd somehow dragged ourselves back in the game immediately through a strike from Højbjerg, a great strike. And you thought, all right, the team all of a sudden looked like they had a bit of belief about them. They looked like they could maybe get back in the game. But the frailties...
From that disallowed goal, it was all done, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, first of all, we got away with one because Firmino, it did hit his hand, but also hit Dier's hand, and he was fouling Firmino, and he only handled it because he was getting fouled and whatever. It was VAR, it probably was a handball, so we got away with it a bit for that one. And then... But it was all wrong. The whole structure of the team was wrong because you could see they were carving us open time after time. And I said in the stream, it was only a matter of time before they get another goal.
Yeah.
It was only a matter of time.
At the end of the day, that goal at the end of the first half was absolutely detrimental to us.
That was the big one for me.
It was absolutely detrimental to us. We got completely outclassed in that game by Liverpool. The better side won 100%. There's no two ways about that.
And you've got to say as well, as soon as we went 3-1, We were playing like we were winning. We were just passing it around. No desire, no urgency to get the ball forward. Whenever Liverpool back line had it or anything, there was no pressing, no belief. We were just giving up. We just wanted the game to end.
What does this mean for our top four hopes now?
Look, obviously we're still in there with the fight because we're only a couple points away with the game in hand. So it's not like it's over. But in terms
of... 4 points behind Liverpool now?
With a game in hand, yeah.
Yeah, so...
Liverpool,
and our game in hand is against Villa. It's not exactly a gimme
game,
is it?
Yeah, but we have to see where we are when we play that game. We could be ahead of them. We don't know. But in terms of the fight for... look, obviously, if there's any lingering title challenges, that's dead for sure today.
I told everyone last week when they started talking about title this, title that.
No,
I don't want to hear about title talks anymore. We got overexcited a couple of months ago. We got put back in our place last month, and now we're seeing our true colours. And I'm sorry, but our defence is not good enough. It is not good enough. Jose can see it. We can see it. Everyone can see it. And that's the plain facts of the matter.
Yeah, and especially individuals. It's all down to individual errors for all the goals, pretty much, which is the most frustrating thing. But I think in terms of when we're 3-1 down, you expect the team to show a little fight. You expect the team to at least give it a go.
The only one was Højbjerg.
Everyone seemed resigned. They just seemed resigned to losing. It's like, oh, we're 3-1 up. We're 3-1 down to the best team in the country. So
not good enough.
So we might as well just rein it in. And Liverpool were toying with us at the end.
Their mentality was not right
today. They were toying with us, Liverpool. Absolutely toying with us.
You know,
today.
Nothing in the game can affect you. Everything in the game can affect us. Everything in the game can affect us. And I'm fuming. I'm absolutely fuming. But look, it is what it is. It doesn't stop. We got Brighton, then we got Chelsea, then West Brom, then Everton in the Cup, then Man City. The games are coming thick and fast now. And if Harry Kane has got an extended injury now, we're fucked.
We're just going to have to hope he's back because we are in serious trouble. Because as soon as he started, that was when the problem started. So, look, I'm not going to say we're not going to win any games without Harry Kane.
He's our best attacker, best midfielder, best defender. How are we going to cope with
that? There's no one who can do the job he can. So just like Mourinho said, you can't replace Van Dijk with anyone but Van Dijk. And the same with Kane for us. We can't replace Kane with anyone else but Harry Kane. So you just got to pray. He's not out for any extended period of time. But even so, look, we got Brighton next. And, you know, even without Kane, you should expect to win that game. I'm sorry. But then you've got a tough run. You've got Chelsea. You've got then Everton in there. You've got City. So
and even West Ham, they're even above us.
And so this really has the potential to derail us with an injury, and the defeat in the manner that we lost really does have the potential to derail us seriously. And that's what I'm worried about. But
it's not The losing bit is not the tough thing to take today. It's the manner in which we lost today. That's the tough thing to take today. I mean, everyone can accept a defeat to Liverpool. They're an absolute class side, no matter what form they're in.
Which made it easy.
Absolute class side. But the absolute manner in the defeat today was not good enough and embarrassing, really.
Yeah, just
the second
like,
half was embarrassing.
Just like you look at the game at Anfield, right? We lost, but everyone's like, okay, we lost, but it was a close game and we did right and we did all right and we could have got something out of that game. You know, can't today, say that tonight.
Nah, you
can't say that today because we were atrocious.
Yeah.
And it was. And I don't think through the tactics, the players on the pitch have got to look at themselves and think about how good they think they are and what they want to be, because they just didn't show anything today, especially in the second half, to show me that they want to challenge for serious things this year. And that's what really disappointed me, because I've had a lot of belief since the beginning of the season that we're going to be onto something big. But today was a real shot in the foot for me.
All right, so there you have it. That is our instant match reaction. Let me know your thoughts on the game in the comment section below. Like, subscribe, and comment. And as always,
come on, you Spurs.